gathered in their masses, just like witches at black masses. In the fields of bodies burning, as the war machine keeps turning, evil minds of plot destruction, sorcerer of death's construction. Say, where are you going? Do the war beast people know?
Osbourne, Black Sabbath.
Damn, this fucking guy's crazy shit, man. Whoa, I got all pumped up for this one, man. I didn't expect it to go on so long, but man, what a song. Singing in the 70s about war pigs. Politicians send their kids away. I don't even know what they're saying. You listen to the words of that song, it's just so powerful. It's like those people over there are starting the wars, you know, and we, you know, we, the poor people, go over and fight them. Not me, I'm too old, but, you know, certainly a bunch of kids coming out of high school, they don't know what they're getting themselves into, and they sign up to be patriotic. Oh, the flag, yeah, flag. The flag is for you, because to be patriotic, you fight in war, and you can die in war, right? So what the hell's going on? What am I talking about war for? We're not at any war, are we? Are we at the moment of war? Is war upon us? Well, sure, it looks like it. So Trump, the three little war pigs, Trump, Pompeo, and John Bolton, it looks like they all want a war. Why? Because the military-industrial complex is breathing down their back to get a war going so that they can make some money, right? So, you know, there's all the false flags going on. The alleged, the U.S. drone allegedly flew into Iranian space and the Iranians shot it down, and, you know, and Iranians, they glued bombs to the side of a tanker. Right? There's no fact, and there's no injury to humans, or especially to Americans on that side of the world. But nonetheless, we're in there, and we're almost ready. Trump and his team are ready to start a goddamn war over it. So Trump ordered military strike on Iran and called it off at the last minute. Ooh. Is that Trump playing 4D chess? Oh, he's so smart. Threaten them with war. Scare the fucking piss out of them with war and call it off at the last minute. That's strategy. That's diplomacy. That's how you negotiate diplomacy or something else. Maybe he just pulled it off the table because, I don't know, it felt like it. Right? It's just, no, we're not ready yet. We'll do it tomorrow. We'll do it next week. So President Trump reportedly gave the order to attack Iran Thursday night in response to its downing of the U.S. drone that Washington claims was in international waters at the time. The U.S. went so far as to maneuver planes and ships into position before the strike was called off. All right. Fake News Times and Fake News Wall Street Journal report, citing a handful of senior officials, that the president was prepared to attack a number of Iranian targets, including radar and missile batteries. However, he eventually gave the word to stand down. There's the drone that got shot down, right? One of them. I've seen many pictures of them. Who even knows what it looks like? Who even knows if it's real? So here's allegedly, this is an interesting diagram, right? It shows you Iran drone shot down here. Iran said it was over the land. And U.S. says it was maybe a couple of miles outside of land. Nonetheless, there probably is international space, right? But why are you flying a drone? Again, I said it yesterday. It's their backyard. I'm not gonna backpedal on that. You have no business having a drone, a $123 million drone that's just a basic giant surveillance system, flying 12 miles off their shore, right? Or even flying inshore. Who knows, right? We don't know. Nobody knows. Where's the debris? Where is the debris fall in the water or the debris fall in the land? Let's find out. Can we at least see the evidence? Can we at least, do we still have any rule of law whatsoever, any common sense to actually look at where the debris of the shot down, you know, camera fell? No. So what is this all about? It's senseless to argue because there is no meaningful reason why we should be instigating a war and flying drones a couple of miles off of their shore and accusing people of blowing up ships with there's no evidence, none. It's just all false flag, right? So journalistic, this is an interesting article too. I'm just going to continue here. No, there's one other one. Right, so McConnell, even, I'll just say this also. It seems that Trump, unfortunately, is a runaway ship, where even the Congress, like in Yemen, for example, the Senate has voted to block Trump administration from selling arms to Saudi Arabia. You remember when he did that? He said, oh, yeah, I'll sell him $880 billion in arms, which is going to Yemen to slaughter people in Yemen, you know, poor people, and instigate wars in Israel and Iraq, right? So interestingly, Congress has stepped up and is trying to block Trump's sale of arms to Saudi Arabia. Now, again, Trump, the Congress voted to end the war in Yemen, and Trump vetoed the bill. Warmonger, a war pig, right? All-out war pig now, right? You could say that he didn't start a war with Iran, right? He didn't start the war with Iran, but they're flying reconnaissance, they're threatening Iran, right? But he certainly is continuing an ongoing war in Yemen by giving them, by fueling the Saudis with weapons. No, inescapable, right? And then vetoes the bill to stop it. The truth of the matter is this. The blatant aggressor is Washington, and the dangerous confrontation now unfolding is utterly unnecessary. Just think about that. Think about for a second what's happening, right? Let's read a little more. Currently threatened escalation of Washington's economic war on Iran into an actual shooting war is a fright case in point. Based on the news coverage since the two oil tankers were damaged yesterday, you'd think that a crew of bloody-minded aggressors in Tehran had up and decided out of the blue to attack the whole world via disrupting its 18 million barrel per day oil lifeline through the Straits of Hormuz. Right? They just decided, they're making money hand over fist, and they just decided to attack a bunch of oil tankers. There's no logic to it. It doesn't make any sense. And that's why it is. Washington is the aggressor, right? So there we are, right? And here's our three little piggies. Right? Here's our three little pigs. Excuse me. I'm going to sneeze. Hope that didn't hurt too much. So that's the fundamental reality. Remember the Maine? Remember that one? The Operation Northwoods, the Gulf of Tonka that started Vietnam, all fake, all false flags. Kuwait incubator babies, remember that story? Saudi's weapons of mass destruction for after 9/11. Right. Gaddafi's soldiers, Viagra spree, that was ridiculous. Right? Last messages from Aleppo, ooh, right? Duma, I don't know what that is. Burning aid on Colombia, Venezuela, and bridge, that was recently, right? They just burned the fucking, right? They were burning aid, saying that the other side was doing it. And meanwhile, they were doing it themselves. And now the attack on the in the Gulf of Oman, right? So it's just nonstop. It's nonstop war. War. It's war, baby. War. Oh.